Leute, welcome back. This is Richard from SchalkeMerica, here to review the TESTSPIEL against Paderborn. An interesting game to say the least. Let's just jump right into it, right? What a game it was. 5-1 victory for the boys. Interesting formation. The team recovered nicely from their previous results, or at least their last result again with a Manuel Baum. The formation came out in a 4-2-3-1, kind of what you know, Baum is known for. In goal, you had Frederick Renau, as we've seen in from the last game against Leipzig. In the defense, you had Newman, Ludwig. In defense, in the central defense, you had Thiao and Stasic, and then left back, you had Ochipka. And the two holding positions and the pivot positions, you had Omar Mascarell and Nabil Bentaleb. The front three attacking players, you had Skripski on the right, Mark Uth in the middle, and then you had Benito Raman on the left. And then, of course, up top, you had a striker, and it was the big man this time, Ibisevic instead of Paciencia. And so I thought that the game was very interesting. We saw much better pressing from the team. Something that we were fully expecting. We saw glimpses of it in the first 20 minutes against Leipzig. But I thought to start the game off, at least the team really pressed really well, especially when they turned the ball over. They were able to press really quickly and try to get the ball back, which is very nice to see, a very change of pace. Also, you saw a lot of fight from the team, a lot of trying to win the balls back. Anytime there's a loose ball, they were going for the 50-50 chances, and they were actually doing really well on the loose balls. So you love to see the fight in the team, because that's been a long time since we've seen a team do any kind of fight. And yes, we know it's a friendly against Paderborn and Zweite Bundesliga. But we weren't sure how good this team was going to do, how well this team was going to play, no matter who the opponent, much less a Zweite Bundesliga opponent. So, and I think another takeaway to take from the game is the combination play between the attackers was really, really good, actually, for a change. You know, with Bentaleb and Skripski, and Raman in the lineup, who hadn't been much in there, they have all played pretty well, especially Skripski and Raman. I thought especially Raman on the left-hand side is creating a lot of opportunities. My player ratings in the game, and just, you know, good, bad, or ugly. Frederick Renau, I thought, played very well. Had some big saves in the game. The early goal, really not his fault. Nothing he could do about it. Ludwig, the new right back, I thought he played a good game. I thought he had a good game. A lot of excitement going down the right wing side. Played well defensively, so overall a good game. Malik Thiao did decent, he did pretty good. I mean, obviously there's no Kabak. Kabak is out with Turkey. Salif Sané, I believe, is with Senegal. Regardless, Nastasic was next to him, and I thought Thiao did a fairly decent job overall. Nastasic was good, was solid. I liked his game overall. It was what you expect from Nastasic. Ochipka had a great game, I thought. Him and Raman and Mascarell really worked really well on the left-hand side. Ochipka was involved a lot throughout the game, especially in some of those goal situations that we'll get to in a bit. But I thought he had a very good game. The two pivot positions, Mascarell, I mean, he's doing what we expect him to do. Played very, very well defensively, linked up the passing from defense to the attack very well. Defensively did his job. Occasionally the passes would go astray. But I thought as an overall complete game, especially him working with Bastian Ochipka, I thought those two worked very well together. And he complemented the attack quite nicely in the game as well. Bentaleb was a nice surprise in this game for me. This is the best game I've seen him with the Royal Blues in a long time, honestly. And very involved in the attack. He was back to some of his trickery, the trickery that actually works, you know, from time to time. He looked decent in this game. Had a nice assist to Mark Uth. So overall in the game, he was good. I mean, he wasn't perfect by any stretch. There were some plays where, you know, you want to see a little bit more from Nabil. But overall, good game. Skripski was a solid game, decent game. At times he disappeared throughout the game, but he came up big in some plays. I had a nice assist on Mark Uth's hat trick that we'll get to, but he had an okay game. If there was a low spot in the team, I would say it would probably be Skripski, and he wasn't that bad. He was decent. Mark Uth, man of the match for me. He had a hat trick, three very nice goals, actually. Won a nice left-footed shot for his first goal. Second goal, a fantastic play. You know, basically a solo play by him with a left-footed shot off the post. And then the third goal, a nice cheeky lob over the goalkeeper to complete the hat trick. So, man of the match for me, no doubt about it. Benito Raman, I thought was very strong in the game. This is a very good game for him. He looked very comfortable on the left wing side. Linked up very well with not only with Mark Uth and Abisevic, but also Bastian Ochipka and even Mascarella at times when he would come in. So a lot of the goals came through Benito Raman. He was heavily involved in the game, and that's excellent to see from a Schalke point of view, because you know, the times we had seen him in, for the most part, he had been very quiet. And yes, again, it's Paderborn, but I thought, you know, the team showed up, and Raman certainly did as well. And then to round out the starting 11, Ibisevic, I think, gives that little bit more than Pacienza. You know, I love Pacienza, and I know many people love Pacienza, but Ibisevic has a little bit of extra of polishing, I guess, if you want to call it. His goal in the game was, I mean, that's a striker's goal right there. Beautiful volley, top shelf. Nothing the keeper could have done about that. The whole play was just beautiful overall. But Ibisevic, a very strong game for me. But again, Uth, man of the match for me. And if I had to pick a second person, I'd probably say Benito Raman or Ochipka, probably up there in that second spot. So what do you guys think about the player ratings? How did you rate the players? Leave us a comment below. Let us know what you thought of the player ratings. Now, I really want to quickly go through all the goals. The first goal of the game was actually scored by Paderborn. Actually, it was a corner kick for Paderborn. A poor clearance by Nabil Bentaleb really cleared it to the top of the box. It fell to Proger with a smashing volley, top shelf, that nothing that Renault could have done about it. So, you know, also on the play, Benito Raman kind of runs past Proger. Really could have done a better job defending there. So outside of those two players there, that shot was very good by Proger, and there was nothing that you could have done about it. So you got to give kudos to the player for getting that goal. But we could have done better on a set piece. Again, set piece seems to be our downfall, which we need to correct, I think, going forward. All right, so the first goal for Schalke was actually a nice one. Started by Mark Uth, and we're going to hear this going over and over again. Off the throw, and he gives it to Ochipka. Ochipka plays a nice give and go with Benito Raman. Ochipka eventually gives it to Mascarell, who slides it over to Bentaleb in the middle, who does a nice through pass to Mark Uth, and with his left-footed shot, low to the far corner, gets the opening goal. And I thought overall it was a nice play, but Mark Uth with a nice start off to that play, and he gets to finish it off. So kudos to him, and really nice play by Bentaleb with the through pass. I thought that was an excellent vision there to catch him. And good, you know, you got to give Benito Raman some credit too, because as a striker and attacker, you want to get that ball. And so you see that ball come in, your tendency is to go for the ball. He let Mark Uth get it. Mark Uth called for it, obviously, and he put it away. So great to see that chemistry and teamwork by all the Royal Blues in that play. Second goal gets created by Omar Mascarell and Bastian Ochipka teaming up defensively to get the ball. Mark Uth would end up picking it up, giving it out wide left to Benito Raman. Raman would switch the play over to the right to Skripski. Skripski would find Mark Uth right in front of the box, and Mark Uth did the rest. Kind of danced around two different players from Paderborn, and then rifled home a left-footed shot off the post and into the goal. A brilliant goal by Mark Uth. Nice play overall by the team. Nice play defensively to kind of lead to that counter. But Mark Uth gets all the credit for this one. I mean, what a way to finish that ball. It was emphatically for his brace in the game, and a 2-1 lead for Schalke at that point of the game. Now the third goal of the game, again, started by Mark Uth. He heads up the pitch, gives it to the right onto Ludwig. Ludwig passes it back to Mascarell. Mascarell had a nice cross pitch pass to Bastian Ochipka, who one time passes it back into the box, finding a streaking Ibisevic, who volleys it beautifully as a striker should. Right at the 45th minute, gives Schalke the 3-1 lead going into halftime. What a beautiful play, tic-tac-toe passing all the way around. Full credit to Ochipka for the one-time pass, and then Ibisevic, a finish that you want a striker to have, and he gets. And something like that kind of leads me to say that maybe he should start over Pacienza. He has a killer instinct he has for years in the Bundesliga, a proven commodity. Maybe he should get the run out to start the games and bring in Pacienza afterwards. But regardless, beautiful goal by Ivicevic and by the club in general. So kudos overall. Now Schalke's fourth goal was something beautiful. Raman ends up getting taken down in the defensive part of the pitch. Omar Mascarell quickly does the restart, gives it to Mark Uth, who brings it up the pitch. He's obviously ahead of his teammates, so he kind of holds on to the ball, evading defenders, trying to wait for his teammates to catch up. Eventually creates some space for himself, sees Benito Raman running back post, and does a beautiful pass over the top and finds Benito Raman with a header for a goal. The smallest man on the pitch outside of Baum getting a header for the goal. Lovely pass by Uth. Full credit on that goal and a nice header by Benito Raman. Well done by the team, and heads up play by Mascarell to start that play quickly and catch Paderborn off guard. So wonderful play over there, and again, beautiful assist for Mark Uth to go with his first two goals of the game. And to round out all the scoring, a throw-in that starts off with the ball ends up to Mark Uth. He gives it to Skripski. Skripski tries to go over defender, lob it over the defender, can't quite control the ball. It's bouncing around in the box. It somehow gets loose, finds its way to Mark Uth. When you're hot, right? And he does a nice cheeky little shot over the goalkeeper to make it 5-1, the hat trick for Mark Uth. Wonderful game overall, I thought, for him. I hope to see this trend continue on into the Bundesliga. I hope for the whole team, not just Mark Uth. But I thought this combination play between all the players out there worked quite well. You definitely see that the second striker position that Mark Uth played there, kind of right behind the striker, was really good for him. Ibisevic was good in that group. The teamwork between him and Raman Ochipka at the left back. Skripski, you could use him or you could try to find someone else there. That's a good place. But, Benteleb and Mascarell look more comfortable together. And it's nice to see Ludovic back there, an actual right back play. I'm happy with the team. I think Renault is going to be a solid player for us in goal. Not that Fairman wasn't, but I think a change of pace maybe was needed overall, and maybe it showed in this game. So let's see. It's a friendly. We're still in the international break. A long way to go. Big game against Union coming up. So let's see how the team plays out. But I'm loving what I see, what I saw from the game. So tell me what you thought. Tell us, the Schalke America, what you thought of the game. What were your overall impressions? Was Mark Uth the man of the match for you? Or if not him, who was? Let us know in the comments. And if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to the page. Again, leave comments. You can follow us on Instagram, Twitter, any social media at Schalke America. So we'll try to put in more content like this, with news and after games. And obviously, we have the podcast. We do live streams also every week. So tune into us each week. And we'll catch you on the flip side. Tschüss.